In this module, we're going to continue our meat and potatoes discussion and talk about backup restore, a hot topic when we talk about moving to the cloud, built-in HADR among all our service tiers, and what you get as far as database availability and consistency, which is really important, as well as how you can configure and monitor your availability to get the availability that meets your organization's requirements.
You know, the capabilities that we have in Azure SQL for availability, to me, is one of the most amazing stories we've built for the cloud that you should think about. We have automatic backups. We even have the ability to user control backups in the case of managed instance. We have built-in high availability and disaster recovery in the form of technology that's going to feel like a failover cluster instance and availability groups. We're going to give you read replicas, even at read scale. We're going to let you go further by protecting your assets in the cloud through things like availability zones, geo-replication and failover groups. We are going to give you insights into the availability of your database and provide you SLAs not seen anywhere else in the industry to keep your application running at all times. Managed instance supports even transactional replications for those kind of type needs you want. You're used to using that in SQL Server, and an Azure SQL database can even be a subscriber to a replication scenario on premises. And then finally, database consistency, which you see a lot in your SQL Server environment, is a great story of how we do a lot of protection and integrity checks behind the scenes for your Azure SQL deployment. And then the tasks you're going to see in this in these series in our module for availability are going to be very familiar to you, like picking the right deployment that meets your R2 and RPO requirements for high availability. You may have some configuration things you need to do from a high availability perspective. We'll talk about and show you how to do that. And finally, we'll show you some of the tools and techniques you can use to monitor the availability of your Azure SQL deployment. Now we've laid the groundwork for what availability is going to be in this module. You've seen the capabilities we're going to talk about, and you see the tasks that we're going to show you when it comes in terms of availability for Azure SQL. We'll see you in the next video.